Our question this week comes from Dylan about his 30-year-old loquat. He's got two trees that are the same size, planted 20 yards apart, but only one is having an issue. Dylan reports that the leaves on one tree are chlorotic, so of course he'd like to know how to correct that. But he's also wondering why only one plant is affected. Although I know it seems illogical to think that two of the same plant in the same landscape could have different issues, I actually get this type of question quite a lot. Not only may the soil and growing conditions change just enough to affect plant health over a much smaller area than we would expect, slight variations in the genetics of the two plants, as well as in their overall health prior to planting, may cause problems that take years to manifest visibly. Most often, the type of intravenal chlorosis seen here is caused by a deficiency of the micronutrient iron. But it could be something else, so I'd recommend that you start out with a soil test. Contact your local county extension service for more information on how to get your soil tested affordably, and also to be sure that you request the correct test. For Dylan's situation, we want to make sure that the test for micronutrients, which isn't usually part of the baseline test. And a complicating factor is our soil pH. Our soil pH in Central Texas is on the alkaline side, which inhibits micronutrient availability. And that means that just adding fertilizer may not actually correct the issue. We've gotten lots of questions about fertilizing trees recently, so we reached out to certified arborist April Rose, Urban Forest Health Coordinator for the City of Austin, to get her take. First, April wanted us to remind folks that plants that are native and well-adapted to Central Texas soils generally don't need fertilizer. But she also pointed out that all plants can benefit from practices that improve soil conditions, such as top dressing with compost and applying mulch. When we nourish the soil, we nourish plants. April also notes that yellowing or chlorotic leaves may be caused by problems that can't be helped with fertilizer, so it's important to rule out other sources of plant stress before applying anything. A certified arborist can help determine the cause of symptoms, and because there may be many factors involved, treatment without diagnosis is not recommended. If a soil or foliar test determines that one or more nutrients is lacking, fertilization can restore the tree's health. But sometimes the required nutrients are already present in the soil, just not available, and adding additional nutrients could lead to toxicity and cause more problems than it solves. Also, excess fertilizer may wash away into streams and creeks and lakes, which can cause problems for other plants and for wildlife. If the ultimate recommendation is to fertilize, the best way to apply fertilizer will depend on site conditions and other environmental factors. Also, you want to ensure that the entire root zone receives treatment. So generally speaking, the more soil volume you can affect, the better for the tree, especially large, older trees. April Rose continues, there are two main ways to fertilize. The simplest method, and often the cheapest, is to broadcast material over the surface of the soil and let gravity and water carry it downward into the root zone. Powders, granules, or pellets can be spread by hand with scoops or shovels, or a wide range of machines that can distribute material evenly over a wide area. In addition to placement, timing is also important. For trees planted in lawns, adding a concentrated chemical to grass during hot weather can scorch leaf surfaces. Compost, if it's well aged and of good quality, can be spread up to half an inch thick at any time of year with little risk to damage the plants. Surface applications of anything, even compost, should always be watered in. This method may not work on lots with steep grades or in severely compacted soils, where a surface application may wash away before it can be absorbed. This not only wastes money, but can kill aquatic wildlife. Another disadvantage of surface application is that the nutrients may be taken up by turf grass roots before they reach the zone of trees. In these cases, deep root fertilization may be needed. This method requires specialized equipment to inject a solution directly into the soil, so generally, professional arborists or landscape companies should be hired to do the work. Although it's more expensive, there are several advantages of deep root applications. The liquid's injected below grass roots, and there's little to no runoff. Also, the solution can be customized to include humates or mycorrhiza. Nutrients are available to the plant more quickly, and they're not as likely to burn plant tissue. We'd love to hear from you. Visit centraltexasgardener.org to send us your questions, pictures, and videos.